It's 2021 and Sony Mobile hasn't seen great success in a couple of years. In 2020, it released two of its biggest and best smartphones in a long time, really. The Xperia 5.2, the lesser of the two releases, was praised by us and other firms for being a step in the right direction. It has a quick, crisp screen, three good cameras, great battery life, solid build quality, and big performance. So what can Sony Mobile do in 2021 to make it that much better and to try and get it back on track to being the powerhouse that it once was? Before we get any further into the video, I urge you to read our Xperia 5.2 review as well as the second opinion article. Those will both be linked in the video description and in the cards. These were written by Eric Zeman and Robert Triggs respectively, and they are brilliant. The first thing that Sony could do to provide more value to its customers is to actually simplify the software a little bit. I'm not saying that Sony's stock plus kind of UI is bad, because it's not, but it is a little inconsistent. It's mostly stock plus in layout and it doesn't stray from stock all that much. It's very clean and it feels pretty light compared to the likes of ColorOS and One UI. There are a few inconsistencies and a few issues where a good quality of life update could really go a long way. For starters, the Pro video apps and Pro camera apps are awesome, but they're a bit finicky for the average user, so you would expect them to use the standard camera app. However, that lacks a few basic features that you see in pretty much every smartphone these days. There's no HDR toggle, no night mode of any description, and you can't pinch to zoom between the lenses. You can pinch to zoom in the individual lenses, but not between them, which seems a little counterintuitive. And unfortunately, this is the same for the Xperia 1.2 as well. As for the gaming features, well, they're all buried away in software submenus and aren't in the place where you'd expect them. Also, there's quite a bit of app fragmentation. Of course, like we said, there are three individual camera apps, which is great because it gives you lots of options, but also it's a little confusing to the average user. But aside from that, there are individual apps for Sony's music, Sony's headphones, the PlayStation app, everything has its own app, and it's not all laid out the same way you'd expect for every single one. It's great that Sony users have this much flexibility, but something like One UI or iOS does this arguably better, because both of those OSs tend to integrate the features and weave them into the overall user experience as opposed to having separate apps for every individual thing. It feels like Sony's UI doesn't really know where it's going. It's got a stock plus kind of setup and it's very clean, it's very light, but it's got lots of fragmented apps that don't really work together in terms of a cohesive design. The second thing that the Japanese giant could do is lower the price of the Xperia 5.2. Hear me out, the base model iPhone 12 is £799 and the Galaxy S20 FE is £699. The Xperia 5.2 is £799. However, Sony at this current moment in the market in 2021 doesn't really have the clout, doesn't really have everything to compete with Samsung and Apple in terms of a volume and overall value standpoint. And even if Sony could, say, match the S20 FE at £699, it puts it in a much better stead to compete with the rest of the market. Remember, Sony hardly has any market share, so it's hardly in a position to demand a lot of money for its smartphones. Of course, Sony would likely have to take some shortcuts to achieve this price drop. The 5.2's hardware is one of its best traits, so that really couldn't go. And the overall hardware and component choice doesn't seem immensely high on the list, so there's not much to give up on here. But perhaps by selling at a lower price, the firm could sell more units and make up for that with the sheer volume. Thirdly, Sony really needs to market this as the people's device. Think about it, no notch, no punch hole, no finicky in-display fingerprint scanner, the inclusion of a headphone port, well-rounded camera setup, speed where it's needed, fantastic build quality, and really good battery life. And of course, it's a bonus feature that it shoots pro-level video and photo, at least in the smartphone world. Here's the thing, video and photo professionals that want to shoot handheld likely already have cameras like Sony's own mirrorless models for raw photos and high bitrate video. And for those on the other side that use their smartphone for the majority of the photo and video taking, they're likely going to want something that's better straight out of the camera, something like Apple's or Samsung stuff. The Xperia 5.2 is in an awkward middle ground because it's not the best straight out of camera, and those pro level features that people want to use, people are probably going to look past them and just use a pro level camera anyway. When you're targeting a device from a company with an already minuscule market share to such a niche market, you can't really expect success, especially not right off the bat anyway. Fingers crossed we see something better from Sony this year, and let us know in the comments what you want to see from them. Please do like, comment and subscribe if you're new around here so you don't miss a video like this one, and check out those articles that I mentioned at the beginning of the video in the video description. Anyway, I've been Ryan Thomas with Android Authority, and I'll catch you later.